So that is the unboxing of the Redragon H510 Zeus 2 gaming headset. But if you want to learn more about this headset right here, then I suggest you stay a while and finish the whole video. It would really be appreciated. Yo, looking into the construction of the H510 Zeus 2, it can easily withstand flex and twist because of its metal frame. The top of the band has this leatherette finish with the Redragon logo imprinted. I did not like the left and right side indicators being printed in the outermost part of the headset, but it's just a personal taste nonetheless. The metal band have these round grooves to make a precise adjustment of the cups. Although the ear cups are made out of plastic, it has this rubber coating which I find unique in most headsets at this price point. Both cups has this rich textured chromed Redragon logo, which I also find awesome. The plastic outer shell has this gunmetal finish, same with the metal band. The gold plated 2.5mm port looks great. Beside it is the mic port. The drivers has this thin foam pad for additional comfort, and the leatherette cushions are really soft and comfy. Though I think it would be better if the cushions are thicker, because I like thick cushions. The bottom part of the band has this red leatherette cushion, which is also soft and comfortable, and has the right thickness in my opinion. The H510 came with a detachable mic with a 2.5mm jack. Redragon also included a microphone. We will have a mic test shortly, so please finish the video. We also have an analog mic and audio adapter for our PC. Connected to it is an 2.5mm jack for our mobile phones, etc. And lastly, we are looking at the well-built control box for our 2.5mm jack, the USB connector. I also love how all of the cables are braided and all of the connectors are gold plated. It simply added strength to its structural integrity and it looks more premium. This is the mic test for the Redragon H510 Zeus 2 gaming headset. It's connected right now to the system unit using the 2.5mm jack to USB cable. To check the noise cancellation features of the mic, I'll now type in random keys on my mechanical keyboard. So this is gonna be a bit loud compared to a membrane keyboard. The keyboard is a few inches away from the mic, probably 15 inches far. I will also do some clicking on my mouse. The mouse is also a few inches far from the mic. No electric fans, but the AC is on. By the way, the pickup level of the mic is at 100%. Okay, there you go. Please be advised, when connecting the mic into the headphone, make sure that you aligned it properly. There's a protrusion guide beside the port and the jack. This is simply to avoid damaging the mic jack and the mic port in the headphone. A big thumbs up to the Redragon engineering team for this. Another heads up, tech noobs, the H510's detachable mic is omnidirectional. It means that it picks up sounds with equal gain from all sides or directions. Okay, if you're still here and you're still watching the video, then thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Anyway, we are almost done. So this is the part where we are going to discuss the things that I like about this headset and the things that I didn't. Let's start off with the things that I didn't like about this headset. Actually, there's only two. The first one is the clamping force of this headset. In my opinion, it's kind of tight. I was using this headset for a couple of weeks now, and I noticed that after a couple of hours, my ears starts to hurt. I am not sure whether I need to flex the band first before using it, or I am not sure whether I have a big head, so I think that's why. But as far as I know, I only have an average size head, so it is what it is. The second thing that I didn't like about this headset is the ear cushions. After a couple of hours of using this headset, my ears starts to get a little bit hot. It's actually not a big deal because the way that the ear cushions are designed, it's the Red Dragon use a leatherette material, and also it's kind of hot here, especially in this month of May. In other words, the ear cushions heating up the ears issue of this headset may still vary depending on the ambient temperature of the room where you will be using this headset. It may not be an issue to some, or it may not be an issue at all. It's not a big deal, but I didn't like it nonetheless. Okay, now for the things that I like about this headset, there's actually a lot, but I narrowed it down to at least three important things. The first one is the design. It's reminiscent of the more popular gaming headset, the HyperX Cloud 2. So I like that. And I love how they accentuate the ear cups with this rubber coating. And the metal frame is coated with gunmetal gray. It looks premium in my opinion. Okay, the second thing that I like about this headset is the sound quality. The highs, the lows, the bass, they are all clean, especially the 7.1 surround sound. I thought at first it was a gimmick, but it's the real thing. I have used this headset for gaming for a couple of weeks now. It never fails. I am not an audio expert whatsoever, but the sound quality on this headset is really good. Last but not the least, the microphone. I was actually expecting this to be crappy because I have several experiences when it comes to headsets with mic, but I was wrong. It's actually really good. The sound is crisp. I have used this to several video call meetings, and even in games when communicating with teammates, they said that it was clear and there's no hisses or there's no weird noise, you know what I mean. So I really liked it. And that is it. If you like the video, please leave a thumbs up. If you have any questions or reactions, leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed, then what are you waiting for? Subscribe now. Help this world become a much better place by subscribing to my channel. Again, this is TechTube Tonyo. Till next time, peace.